only love me cause I'm popping. This a layup, this a rebound, then it's robbing. Tyson with the fade, not the air, my hands rocking. When I link with ballpoint, you know it's not, 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 knocking. I'm not the same, thinking money made me change, nothing else to blame. Need a money counter, I broke my thumb from thumbing down. Wifey on my line, she told me to dumb it down. Mama on my line, asking how I'm dumber now. I think you only love me cause I'm poppin'. This a layup, this a rebound, then it's driving.
Drop a like in the next 5 seconds or this will happen to you. Your next game of NBA 2K22. I wouldn't risk it. Real quick, for the people who follow me on Twitter and Instagram, I still don't know what's fully wrong with me health-wise. It's honestly a little complicated, but I'm also not trying to bore y'all. So for the people who care, I talk about it more in depth at the end of the video. Brief summary, basically, I won't know what's fully wrong until the end of the week. So until then, I'm gonna do what I've always done and use YouTube as a distraction from my real life. Let's get into this. What's up, Simply Squad? It's your boy Demigod grinding. And let me guess, you're already bored of NBA 2K22. You're probably tired of seeing the same old play shots do the same old moves every game, but at the same time, you have to do the same thing because you don't want to lose. Well, what if I told you that there's a build out there that moves just as fast and can green just as consistently as a play shot, but also gets contact dunks, has the ability to get snatch blocks, on almost forgot, is 6'7" on NBA 2K22. You'd have to call that build a demigod, right? Because at that point, it can do everything. Well, that's exactly what we got today. This game-breaking build can single-handedly change the meta on NBA 2K22. You don't believe me? Look how fast this build is moving in these clips. The speed of this build combined with its elite finishing and the fact that it's 6'7" literally forces people to sag off to try and stop you. But when they do, they either get dunked on or it's an easy wide open green from three. There's really no answer to this build. The only limit to this build is how good the player controlling the build is. So in today's video, first I'm gonna show you exactly what this build can do, then I'm gonna show you how to make it, then I'm gonna give you the best dribble moves, badges, and jump shot so you feel completely comfortable with making this build for your season 2 grind. Now to make this demigod build, you're gonna need to buy some VC, which leads us into today's sponsor. This video is sponsored by Current, the future of mobile banking. Current lets you complete all your banking needs from the comfort of your own home. Yeah, you heard that right. You don't even have to get off the game and go outside. Current is perfect for no-lifes like me and you because you can do all your banking needs online. But not only that, there's absolutely zero hidden fees. You're able to get your paycheck early and you're also able to customize your cashback options to places you already shop. Overall, Current just takes all the hassle and confusion out of banking. And when you sign up, they will send you a very clean looking debit card. This is mine. And there is literally no reason not to sign up because the basic account is absolutely free and the premium account is only $4.99. So if you're trying to sign up for Current, either go to current.com/grindingdf or click the link at the top of the description. Thank you so much to Current for sponsoring this video and let's get into this, y'all. All right, y'all, let's get into what this build can really do. The first thing I want to test out is how consistent can you green threes with this build? The reason for that is because the first thing you're gonna notice when I show you the attributes for this build is that compared to play shots, this build has a relatively low three-point rating. So I wanna see how much that low three-point rating affects this build. Can people literally just sag off you and wait for you to miss to get the ball back? To test this out, I got on the threes court, I got my friend on my account to sit corner, and I had one goal and one goal only, to three hunt. This game I'm showing you right here, I even felt like a play shot for most of it because I was playing exactly like I do on my play shot. I was running around the three-point line trying to get an inch of space to green the three. I did this three times back to back to back and finished with a green every single time. The fact that you could do it that fast with a player that's 6'7" is insane. Now this right here is more how the build is supposed to look. Basically, you're supposed to bully the smaller guards until they realize they can't guard you in the paint, switch their center on you, and then abuse the center with your speed. The best way I could describe this build is a walking mismatch. On twos, if you play the one, the guards are gonna be way too small to guard you. And if you play the two, the center is gonna be way too slow to guard you. So either way, it's an automatic bucket, which is why I said the only limit to this build is how good the person controlling it is. I only spent like 2 hours on Arzen's account, and by the end of it, I was already confident enough to three hunt most games. I'm telling you right now, if any of y'all make this build and actually put time and effort into mastering your playstyle on this build, you're literally gonna be one of the most unguardable people on NBA 2K22. I will stand by this statement. It is actually impossible to stop someone who has mastered ISOing on this build. It low-key reminds me of the two-way slash and playmaker on 2K20, and y'all remember how dominant that build was. Alright, I think y'all get the point. Let's get into how to make this build, the best badges, the best jump shot, everything you need to know about this build. Alright y'all, now the build. The build for this video is actually going to be a power forward. Now I want you to do me a favor, somebody in the comments, make this exact same build as a small forward, because I want to see how the attributes change. I know as a power forward you get more badges, but I want to see how different the small forward attributes are to a power forward. So if someone could do that for me, that would be great. You can go left or right-handed. I'm right-handed. We're going right. Now for the pie chart, we're going to be going this half red, half yellow pie chart. Like I said before, the low three-point rating was something I needed to test out. And as I showed y'all, we tested it out. You can shoot very consistently with a low three-point rating. The physical profile for this build, we're going to be doing the one with the most speed. In the attributes, the first thing you're going to upgrade is your driving layup and your driving dunk. Now these are the only finishing attributes you're going to upgrade. And you're probably like, yo, Grindy, you only get one finishing badge? And yes, you are only gonna get one finishing badge, but just like I showed y'all in the video, you could get amazing contact dunks with just bronze, posterizer, and no slashing takeover. The next attributes you're gonna upgrade are all of your shooting attributes. We're gonna tweak these in a second. We'll come back to it. After that, we're gonna do all your playmaking attributes. Again, we're gonna tweak this in a second. Finally, my favorite part about this build, the defense. You get to upgrade your defensive rebound, your offensive rebound, your block, your lateral quickness, and your interior defense when making this build. Calling this build a defensive powerhouse isn't even doing you justice. The defense is insane. Now let's tweak this a little bit before we max out all of our attributes. So we're gonna take our post fade down to 62, which leaves us with 9 shooting badges. Trust me, more than enough. I showed you already, you could shoot very consistently with this build. We're gonna take our post control down 1 attribute. And finally, we're gonna put our perimeter defense at 62, which as you can see gives us an extra defensive badge. Now these badges are absolutely maximized for the attributes we need. If you take down one on anything, you lose a badge upgrade. So this is perfectly maximized for everything we need. It honestly doesn't matter, but for me, I would want to go define your height. As the video title states, you are 6'7". Your weight, you're actually going to go exactly 188 pounds as you get no benefits from going minimum weight. You just lose interior defense. So you're going to want to go 188 pounds. And this is the most important part of the build right here, your wingspan. Now, if you go all the way down, you get a couple extra 3-point, but you lose so much in return. It is just not worth it. You're actually going to want to make this build with max wingspan. The reason being, you don't lose much. -2 on 3-point. -1 on ball handling. And look how many positives you get. +6 on block, +4 on rebounding. Plus, you have max wingspan, which we all know means you're going to be a menace to society on the court. Max wingspan on this build is amazing. And at 99 overall, you're going to have +4 on all your attributes. You're going to have a 65 3-point. You're going to have an 80 ball handling, which means all the dribble moves you've ever wanted, including Trae Young, you could get. This is just the perfect build at 99 overall. Now, your takeovers. These are the takeovers you're going to be able to get. If I wasn't a YouTuber, I would honestly probably go slashing take just so people would leave me open way more often. But I'm a content creator,
So I'm going to go play make and take. I know that people just hold B and you barely get ankle breakers, but on the off chance I get an ankle breaker, it's going to make a fire video. So I'm going playmaking take. Y'all could go whatever you want. And there you have it. You have built a playmaking glass cleaner. One of the most overpowered builds on 2K20. And probably the most overpowered on NBA 2K22.
Now for the badges. Now for some reason it's doing some weird glitch today where it says I have 16 defensive badges. I don't really know what's going on. Like 2K, are we okay? I've literally remade the build twice and it keeps saying I have 16 when we literally had 21. Maybe I'm just dumb and I'm missing something. Y'all let me know in the comments. But I'm gonna show y'all what badges I would put on. Gold Hot Zone Hunter, Bronze Deadeye, Bronze Green Machine, Silver Sniper, Bronze Stop and Pop, and if I had the extra badge, which I should, I would put Green Machine on Silver, actually. For playmaking, we're gonna do Hall of Fame Bullet Passer, Hall of Fame Quick First Step, Hall of Fame Quick Chain, Hall of Fame Handles for Days, Bronze Bailout, and Bronze Unpluckable. For defensive rebounding, again, we should have 21. I don't know what's going on, but I would go Intimidator on Hall of Fame, Clamps on Hall of Fame, Chase Down Artist on Bronze. If you're playing the 2 for your team, Brick Wall, I would put on Hall of Fame, but I'm playing the 1 for mine, so I'm not gonna do it. Rebound Chaser on Bronze, Tireless Defender on Bronze, Pickpocket on Bronze, Pogo Stick on Silver, and Interceptor on Silver. If I had my 5 extra badges, I would put Menace on Gold and Rim Protector on Silver to finish out the build. Y'all let me know if you have the same problem. Now I'm gonna give you all the animations, the dribble moves, and the jump shot for this build. For the dribble moves, I'm actually screenshotting Arzen's build video on this build. Make sure to go sub to Arzen. His channel will be linked in the description. He'll be able to answer all your questions about the build, as well as give you the jump shot, because I just realized I don't know what jump shot he has on. I was using my jump shot for when I hopped on his account, and my jump shot's honestly too quick for people that are 6'7". So if y'all want to know his jump shot, go drop him a sub and comment on his most recent video. He'll 100% answer you.
I'm not gonna lie, I never thought it would be this hard to make such a simple build video. So as promised, a little update for those of y'all that care. For the past 4 days, I have been on bed rest, today being the only day where I felt like I could get up and actually do something because I was feeling a little better. About 2 days after I was on bed rest, I tweeted to y'all telling y'all what was going on, because I didn't want y'all to think I was just sitting here being lazy doing nothing. Like, there is nothing I want to do more than grind right now. Like, I promise you, this sucks. I was just getting used to streaming 10 to 12 hours a day on Facebook. I was killing it on videos. I uploaded more videos in a month than I ever have in my life. We were in a great swing, and then of course health problems come and ruin it, but it is what it is. So anyways, yesterday I woke up and I had the worst pain in my stomach I've ever felt in my life. So I went to the hospital that day, and this is where it gets a little confusing. See, I went to the hospital already knowing what was wrong. I don't know if y'all seen this because it was 2K21 next gen, but in one of my next gen videos, I told y'all that I have 2 lifelong health conditions. Now, these 2 health conditions don't bother me for most of the year. They go into remission, which means they don't show symptoms for most of the year. I take my meds every single day. I keep them in check, everything like that. But when they do happen, they hurt. Now, this is where it's confusing again. So I could tell that both of them were acting up because there's 2 pairs of symptoms and I was experiencing both pairs of symptoms, right? Which again is not a fun time. But what I don't know is why it's happening. So like, I know what's wrong, but I don't know what's wrong. You get what I'm saying? Like, I don't know what part of my body is messing up right now. So I went to the hospital. They told me some theories. Some of them were low-key scary, so I refused to believe them. But they had some like ideas of what it could be. But basically, they sent me home. They were like, yo, you just gotta tough it out for a couple days until we do this procedure to find out exactly what's wrong. Which is exactly why I made this video, because if I had to lay in bed all day for 1 more day, I was gonna lose my mind. So in conclusion, no, I'm not fully back yet. I'm just trying to distract myself until I get this procedure later this week. But I'm also gonna be smart about this for once, so I'm gonna take it easy this start of season 2. For my Facebook people, first of all, I love y'all. Second of all, y'all might not see a stream from me until Friday or Saturday maybe, because by then I'll fully know what's wrong and they'll probably have given me new medication to deal with it. So I think I should be fine then, unless I'm in like so much pain that I can't do it. But I'm thinking Friday or Saturday should be good. As for videos, I'm not gonna lie to you, I don't think I'll post another video until like that Monday. And again, I'm sorry. Trust me, there is nobody more frustrated with all of this than me. I just want to say thank y'all to everybody watching this video and everybody who has ever supported me throughout the years. So again, I'll probably start playing season 2 on Friday. If I do play on Thursday, it'll be like Thursday night, but I really don't don't think I'll be able to do that. Unless I get the news early, who knows? If I do, I'll tweet y'all, I'll let y'all know if I'm okay or not. But to be safe, my plan is I'll play season 2 on Friday. I'll probably start streaming it on Friday or Saturday, and then the videos will resume normally on Monday, assuming that nothing like horribly wrong is going on, which I don't think so because I've been getting a lot better the past 2 days, but we'll see. All right, that's enough talking. I'm sorry for making this video a little longer than it needed to be, but I wanted to give you an update so you don't worry about me. I'll be fine, I promise, we'll be good. I was honestly planning on keeping this whole thing private, but when I found out how many days I had to be on bed rest, I didn't want y'all to think like, yo, Grinding's just ditching us again. I'm never doing that ever again. I promise you. But anyways, y'all, thank you so much for watching. I love you all. And as always, keep grinding. Balling. 2K, we never be falling. Retro, she never be calling. Still hitting shots while they steady be taunting. Balling. 2K, we never be falling. Retro, she never be calling. Still hitting shots while they steady